I narrate a story which I think goes back to my early days, and I still remember, much before the gender diversity became a buzzword. It was 35 years back. It was this colleague of mine, an outstanding professional, working with a great organization, and his wife, when he married, was even more brilliant. And she was an outstanding, accomplished lady. And he earlier in life realized that she can do much better in life than he can do. And he realized that if, look, he enforces his career on her, she won't be able to grow. And what happens to children? And this guy, and I'm telling you the early 80s, took a conscious call that I will go slow on my career, let my wife build a career, and I will take care of the family. I'll keep working. This gentleman did not grow in the job for 30 years. He retired in the same job. But he brought up the best kids, most accomplished kids. The wife went on to become the vice chancellor of the biggest university in India, and the family was the happiest family. So I'm saying that is where the maturity comes. So both at the family front and the organization front.
It's a social issue, it's a social problem that needs to be tackled in order that women continue making a contribution to the workforce and the economy. And the role that that needs to be really redefined is the role of the father, the husband, the brother, and the children. And this is where, you know, people have to step in and understand that the mother or the sister or the wife who's coming back from work is just as tired as you are. So main thak gaya hu aur pair upar karke TV dekho, ye baat sahi nahi hai. This, the woman has an equal right to do it. And if both can share the responsibilities of the house in a manner and shape and form, that not only one person is fully responsible for sort of holding up the household end, then it'll make it much easier for the woman to go back to the workforce as soon as possible.
We have had women chairpersons and chairmen of the banks, and a large number of the Indian banking and financial institutions are run by them. So when you look at this, you will find that really from society's perspective, and many of these women would have started their work life 25, 30 years ago, because you know you have to work your way up through the system. And I guess we need to celebrate those successes far more than, you know, always focusing on as if disadvantageous position or we haven't done enough. Because the more you showcase the success, the more you'll be able to motivate people for even greater success.